同学们，今天我们来学习 V 不 V and A 不 A。 Why they are very awkward? What means of V? V means verb, 动词 verb. A means adjective. So the structure is verb plus 不 plus verb.Adjective plus 不 plus adjective. Okay, now let's look at the new words we should use in this lecture. Here, first of all, 太 adverb is only one adverb, 太. And then it's doing so many nouns and the preposition and adjective. Okay, now please read after me.太太学校学校宿舍宿舍同屋同屋室友室友空调空调电视电视里里外外离离远远近近 Okay, the first one, 太 is an adverb, right? 太 it means very and too. Okay, we usually use adverb to, together with adjective like 最近天气太冷了太 is very cold. It's too cold. 太冷了。Okay, 最近身体太累了。身体 what's mean 身体啊、body, health condition. 身体最近身体太累了。I'm very tired. I'm too tired recently. Okay, and 汉语。太难了、汉语太难了 is very difficult、Chinese is very difficult, it's too difficult. Do you think so? Do you agree with it? Okay, so let's conclude. We will use 太 plus adjective plus 了 We put adjective in the middle part. We could use 太 and 了Okay, we can't use only with 太. 太冷 is not right. 太冷了 is right. Okay, and now let's continue here. The second one, 第二个就是学校，这是学校，学校，学校。啊，我们学过去学校。回学校学校 How about this one? 学校里有没有 Okay, we're good. 宿舍宿舍宿舍 is dormitory. So there here is the one bed, the second bed, the third bed. Yeah, so in one room, there are, I guess, maybe four students. Yeah, it's a small dormitory. Okay, so 宿舍宿舍 So what kind of person 宿舍 is for? So usually, 宿舍 is for students or soldiers. Alright, so 宿舍 we can say 学生宿舍 For student, 学生宿舍学生宿舍 Alright, you can see the shape of 舍 just like the ceiling, just like it is a small horse. Okay, the shape of 舍 is like a horse. Okay, and continue next one. Okay, 在宿舍里 in the dormitory, 在宿舍里 we have a...Okay, very good. Roommate. So, 同屋同屋同屋 is an old-fashioned word. an old-fashioned word, but usually at the moment, nowadays, recently we use, yes, 室友室友 But in the dialogue today, we still use 同屋同屋 because it is old teaching material, so we still use 同屋 But nowadays, we call our roommate 室友室友 Yes, 友 means friend, a friend who live in the shared room, so we say 室友、室友 And 你有没有同屋Do you have a roommate or not? 有没有、Do you have? Do you have a roommate or not?、你有没有同屋、Yes, I do. 我有我有同屋 All right, and let's continue next one. So what's this? 这是什么这是什么、Air conditioner. So this is 空调空调这是空调空调 Here, so please turn on the air conditioner Here, so 吹空调吹空调在夏天人们经常吹空调 OK, people turn on the air conditioner in summer 吹空调To blow the wind from the air conditioner, so we say 吹吹空调 Here, turn on the air conditioner, 空调 All right, the next one. Here, yes, this one here is very easy. TV, so 电视电视 Now watch TV. Okay, very good. 看看电视看电视你喜欢看电视吗 Do you like watching TV? And next one So it is 理理 Yeah, here is a bottle Butterfly 蝴蝶 Butterfly in the bottle 理 Butterfly in the bottle 理 AndButterfly outside the bottle. Outside the bottle. Why? Why? In 里里 Outside. Why? Why? So roses in the paper bag. 里里 Rose outside.Why? Why? Outside. Why? In. 里 But here is a strange rule. Do remember it. In English, we usually put in,in front of the place. But in Chinese, we can say 教室里宿舍里食堂里食堂 dining hall 食堂 dining hall 宿舍 dormitory 就是 classroom So if we use English we should say in the classroom in the dormitory in the dining hall But in Chinese we should say 教室里宿舍里食堂里 So usually the rule is some places plus 里Places is in the front, alright, equals to in somewhere in English, alright, 宿舍里、教室里宿舍里食堂里 And we continue, 里 Just now, the word is 里 Third tone, and now this one, this preposition is 里 Here, the second tone, 里 Here, usually,It used like in such a structure. It's a fixed sentence structure. You cannot change it. Like A, 远离 B. Here, A, 离 B, 远 A, 离 B, 近 Here, give us example, please. So here is the example. 他是谁他是谁、他是西蒙 Simon, 西蒙，这是 library, 这是 library, 这是 pyramid, 金字塔，这是 pyramid, 金字塔。西蒙离图书馆远不远？西蒙离 library 远不远？西蒙离 library 近。西蒙离 library 近。西蒙离金字塔远不远？西蒙离金字塔远不远？西蒙离金字塔远。西蒙离金字塔远。Okay, how about the second example? How look at it? So where is Egypt? 埃及在哪里？ So here is Egypt. Alright, Egypt. 埃及离利比亚远不远？利比亚。Here is Libya, Egypt. So, 埃及离利比亚远不远？ Is Egypt far away from Libya? No, alright. 埃及离利比亚不远。We also could say, 埃及离利比亚很近。So, 埃及离利比亚不远。埃及离利比亚很近。远。Here and 近。Here they are opposite adjective. And 埃及离安哥拉远不远？埃及离安哥拉远不远？Yes, 埃及离安哥拉很远。 Okay, so this is 离。 And now here, let's move to step 2, listen. Okay, so this is, 这是西蒙， this is Simon. 这是西蒙的妈妈，这是西蒙的妈妈。西蒙搬到了宿舍，西蒙的宿舍。 So this is Simon's dormitory, 西蒙的宿舍。 And Simon's mom called him to ask about his dormitory. And let's listen to the talk. Please tell me, what are they talking about?
你的宿舍大不大？
我的宿舍不太大。
宿舍里有没有空调？
宿舍里有空调。
你有没有同屋？
我没有同屋。
你的宿舍离教室远不远？
我的宿舍离教室很近。
Alright, that's all for the talk. Have you mastered the talk? Do you understand it? Yes, if you can understand, you are so good. Alright, and let's listen to it for the second time.
你的宿舍大不大？
我的宿舍不太大。
宿舍里有没有空调？
宿舍里有空调。
你有没有同屋？
我没有同屋。
你的宿舍离教室远不远？
我的宿舍离教室很近。
Okay, now let's come to this dialogue. The first question is, yeah, mom asked, 你的宿舍大不大？大不大？Alright, the second is, 宿舍里有没有空调？宿舍里。So the first question is 宿舍。The second one is 里。Why? Because the first one is Is your dormitory big or not? Is your dormitory big or not? I just ask about your dormitory. And the second one, 宿舍里有没有空调? Inside your dormitory, is there air conditioner? Inside your dormitory. So we called, so we say, 宿舍里 in Chinese.Okay, how about the third question? What's the third question? Simon's mom asked, 你有没有同屋? Do you have? 什么是同屋? 同屋是 okay, very good, roommate, roommate. And if we change into another word is, yes, very good, 室友, 你有没有同屋?你有没有室友? And the next one is, the last question, 你的宿舍离教室远不远? Okay, just only mentioned, A, 离 B, 远不远? Okay, and, yeah, please look at all of the right, letter, right words, 大不大? 有没有? 有没有? 远不远?So, 大不大? Adjective plus adjective. Here, 远不远? Adjective plus 不 plus adjective. 有没有? 有 is verb. Do you have or not? Is there something or not? Alright? So, 有 is verb. 有没有? Verb plus 不 plus verb.Okay, and how to answer such questions? So we usually use 大不大? Yes, it's 大. Here, 有没有? 有. 远不远? 远. Alright, so this is. And this is the positive answer. How about the negative answer? Yes, 大不大? 不大. 有没有? 没有. 远不远? 不远. So we choose the last two. The last two words. The last two words to show is negative. So we choose, the first word. The first word as the positive answer.Okay, and let's continue. So, positive answer, 大,有,远,大,有,远. And the negative, 不大,没有,没有,不远. So, it's very easy to answer, right? And sometimes, here, do you still remember that in the last part, we have learned we could put several other adverbs in front of adjective to modify the degree.Like, 你的宿舍大不大?大。你的宿舍大不大?非常大。你的宿舍大不大?大极了。非常大。很大。比较大。不太大。Do you still remember it? Okay. Let's continue. Okay. Read after me. 跟我一起读。你的宿舍大不大?你的宿舍大不大?我的宿舍不太大，我的宿舍不太大。宿舍里有没有空调？宿舍里有没有空调？宿舍里有空调，宿舍里有空调。你有没有同屋？你有没有同屋？我没有同屋，我没有同屋。你的宿舍离教室远不远？你的宿舍离教室远不远？我的宿舍离教室很近。我的宿舍离教室很近。Okay, now it's your turn. Please open your mouth and answer my question. The first one. Yes, it is a classroom, 教室。大不大? Alright, here, so my question is, 教室大不大? 教室大不大? How to answer me? Okay, 教室大。教室里人多不多? 教室里人多不多? So inside the classroom, is there a lot of, are there a lot of people? Inside the classroom, all right, 教室里。But just now we mentioned, 教室大不大? I just want to ask about the classroom, not inside the classroom, so there is a little difference. 教室里人多不多?教室里人很多,很 adverb modify adjective. So we have learned, 非常,非常多,很多,教室里人挺多的,教室里人比较多,教室里的人多极了 ,or 教室里人不太多。Okay, so all of the adverb, if you want to know all of the adverb, you can find part one video part one to review it. Okay, and let's continue. 教室里有没有学生?有没有学生?positive answer, 教室里有学生。Okay, 那教室里有没有桌子?教室里有没有桌子?桌子,桌子。OK, positive, 教室里有桌子。教室里有没有黑板?黑板。Positive, OK, 教室里有黑板。教室里有没有老师?教室里有没有老师?No, negative, 教室里没有老师。This is, 这是宿舍,宿舍 dormitory, 教室,教室 classroom, 宿舍里教室远不远?宿舍离教室远不远?宿舍离教室不远，宿舍离教室挺近。Okay, so in this lecture, we learned 微不微 or A 不 A. We is verb, so we could use 教室里有没有空调 It's verb, plus 没 plus 有 So this is 微不微 pattern.那 A 不 A adjective plus 不 plus adjective like 大不大远不远 Okay, and the, how to answer the questions here if positive we just choose the first word Okay, it's very easy the first word to answer 大有远 If it's a negative answer we could choose the last two words The last two words like 不大没有没有不远 Alright, it's very easy to remember, right? And do remember we can put the adverb So many adverb like 非常很挺的比较不太急了 Alright, okay, we can use adverb to modify this adjective Okay, but by the way 微不微 equals to subject plus adverb, adjective, or plus verb plus ma. Today, the sentence structure today equals to the sentence pattern in part one. Okay, like, 你的宿舍大不大?你的宿舍大吗?宿舍里有没有空调?宿舍里有空调吗?你有没有同屋?你有同屋吗?你的宿舍离教室远不远?你的宿舍离教室远吗? Alright, so that's all for today.And here is the assignment. Here, could you please use the pictures in the following part to tell me, what's your home like? Okay, what's your home like? You could say, you could use for example,
你家有没有空调？你家有没有空调？你家有空调吗？啊，你家有空调吗？
嗯，我家有空调。
你家有没有？有没有电视？你家有电视吗？
你家有电，我家有电视。
你家有没有桌子？你家有没有桌子？
我家有桌子。
你家有没有床？你家有没有床？你家有床吗？
我家有床。
Just use all of the pictures to ask and answer and show me what's your home like. So this is assignment. Thank you for your listening. Bye bye.